What is the work of the Spirit of God? It is to accomplish what cannot be accomplished in any other way, by any other route. The Bible is so clear on this. If you read Ephesians 2, he says, when you were dead in your trespasses and in your sins, you were made alive in Christ. How can dead people come to life? It'll take a miracle. You see, this is the gospel. The gospel is not a word of encouragement to those who are sort of well-meaning people who would like to add a little religion. It is not a word of encouragement to those who would like to have a little Jesus in their life. No, the word of the gospel is a word that comes to the rebel heart. I am a rebel against God. I may be indifferent to him, I may be antagonistic to him, but I'm actually rebelling against him. He then comes by the Bible and he says, I'm commanding you to do an about turn, to repent of your sins and to believe in me. And the individual says, there is no way that that is going to happen. It'll take a miracle for that to happen. Yes, it will. And that is the miracle of regeneration.
Let's start with the microphone check, 1, 2, first. Water to the dry and weary soul of the true church. The kind of things that few search, they say that the truth hurts. Well, this pain is gained, so let's explain the new birth. First things first, can't neglect this at the start. I must preface my remarks with the deadness of the heart. From original sin, the effects of the fall. The sin of our first parents brought death to us all. Since Adam was our federal head, what he did counted for us. In him were all rebels and dead. Yo, captured in the mind, disaster, sin and crimes in a dark state. Alaska in the wintertime, sour in our frames. Left to ourselves, we be devoured in the flames. Cause we're powerless to change. If you feel that weight, I pray that you respond happily, as you see what Jesus had to say in John chapter 3. You'll see that verse 1 is my thesis. It's the deepest truth that should get you speechless. What scripture teaches will fill in the missing pieces. Picture Jesus meeting up with Nicodemus. Perhaps it was fright about the other Pharisees' wicked spite against Christ that turned this into naked night. He called the rabbi and gave him props, said he was a teacher from God. Jesus' reply made him stop. Regarding the kingdom of God, no one's going in. In fact, you can't even see it unless you're born again. That must have consumed and stretched his mind, cause he said,
can a man enter his mother's womb a second time?
Naturalistically, the only way for him to hear it, Jesus said you must be born of the water and the spirit. No other way to enter heaven. That sounds like Ezekiel 36, 25 to 27. In this new birth, the spirit is the source and the agent. The water symbolizes spiritual purification. Yeah. Flesh can only produce flesh, that's true and factual. Regenerating work of the spirit is supernatural. It's kinda like the wind, which is free, east to west, can't perceive the steps. You can only see its effects. In the same way, the Holy Spirit chooses whom he pleases to sovereignly open their eyes to the truth of Jesus. If it wasn't for the Spirit's mysterious operation, we would all be under serious condemnation. I'd still be rejecting the Son if God hadn't said, let there be light, like Genesis 1. Yeah. And just like the light could not refuse to shine. Irresistible grace has renewed my mind. Let's exalt the King who died and truly is risen. The new birth is not the effect of human decision, but the cause. It changes our natural habitation and situation. It's a radical transformation. I was cursed and polluted, so my dirt was inexcusable. With new internal pupils, His person is beautiful. His worth is indisputable. The Lamb is amazing. A standing ovation for His work in the crucible. So let us respond with true worship and love to the God who has given new birth from above. Thank you.